Hi, Carol here, and a great big warm welcome to my craft room in 2017. It's been a few weeks since I've been on YouTube. I'm just getting over pneumonia and decided to take some time off, but I'm back and I decided to make some bright colors and a wonderful aquarium project for you. I think you're going to love it. It's going to be, look at that, doesn't that look like George the monkey? You know, Where's George or whatever it is, a cartoon from many moons ago. And I wanted to come back with my first card to be an interactive card and an actual Go Fish card. We're going to make a fishing pole and we're going to start out with thick acetate, our alcohol inks, of course. I'm pounding out the dark colors first as an undertone just to see what I am going to want on here. And then I'm blowing them with my Copic air compressor gun and moving it around so I could make room for some bright colors. And this is an excellent way. You can do it with an air gun, one of those computer keyboard spray cleaners. You could use that, and or you could just leave it plain. I don't think it would make any difference because we're going to put two pieces of acetate and smush it together to create the background for our wonderful card. And it's going to be the background for the aquarium. So I'm lifting up the first layer and I'm adding the colors and I am moving them around because I want to have some air bubbles all around. And you'll see that in just a minute. There we go. And then I'm going to grab some red, I think, and yellow, and then just set them in, set the acetate down. And you can move this around, especially when, look at my finger as I just drag these colors. And then if you grab some of the alcohol blender solution, it will make those bubbles for you on purpose. How great is that? We're going to cut the section off around the acetate. Now this is my thickest pieces of acetate. I put one on top of the other. And we're going to have to put scotch tape around the edges and secure them double fold. So just fold them over and that way you're not going to leak out any of your alcohol inks. And then I took some chopsticks and one of these is the perfect length to make our fishing rod. It's going to be wonderful. We're going to use magnets. It's going to be a birthday card for, I'd say, between the ages of 3 to 6 would really enjoy this card. And it's an interactive game as well. And I had to edit down 11 hours. I worked 11 hours of tape time and get it under 50 minutes. So you know I was working hard to bring it down, but yet be able to show you all of the elements. So let's start right here, okay? Now for the actual tank itself, I took a sheet of 140-pound cardstock. I scored each piece 3 times on each side, 1/2 inch. So I'm going in 1/2 inch at first. And I put it on my Martha Stewart board and I used my stylus so it was nice and deep. And I found this worked well with a thicker cardstock, but you can use whatever you want. I'm also going to be putting some mink foil over top. So it's going to be quite a thick aquarium. So I'll show you how this is going to look once we get it scored. And I have not seen this particular craft on YouTube. I totally made this up myself and I hope you really like it. So I'm going to take the corners out first and I had to design this as I went. I wasn't quite sure how it was going to get put together, but I just worked on it. I think 3 days, I think I said, that I came up into the craft room and I sure missed everybody. And if I haven't got to your comments, I will certainly get to them. I hope everybody had a blessed Christmas and a wonderful new year. And I can't wait to get started in my craft room making some great projects for you. So let's move along, and we're going to score these now. So as you can see, you have three score marks. So let's bring them up. And right now I want the front of it to look like a frame, like a box frame. And I took the corners up, but then I stopped and I decided I'm going to make this 2 inches across. I'm adding another score line. So you're going to have four score lines because each side has 2 inches, right? So this is going to help me. I'm going to cut out another section there. So you have that little box all the way into the four scored marks, and I'll show you why. The two outside score marks we are going to make fold in so that it's kind of like a column, a square column. And that's an oxymoron, isn't it? A square column. And then the outside pieces, like the top and the bottom, they are only going to fold in once. So it won't make any sense right now, but in just a minute, you'll see exactly what I mean. This is going to be actually quite unique, and I love the concept of having the fish down in a gully, but yet having the acetate piece floating from the 1 inch mark inside this card base. And I'll show you how we're going to do that. We're going to make an accordion sheet 2 inches by 5 inches, scored at a half an inch all the way across. So you'll have four score marks at a half an inch. And I would stand there and just think, okay, what do I have to do? And right now I have to cut some of it off. So if I cut some of this off, I have to get my scotch tape and I have to make sure I secure it on the end so I don't have any of the alcohol ink leak. And I want it to be a little longer so that I get a bevel. I want to bevel it inside the aquarium, almost like a little S, so that when the fish went in there, and I'm actually going to hang the fish open so that they can move back and forth like a bell. And it just gives a wonderful effect of the fish swimming. And look at all those wonderful bubbles. Isn't it sweet? So now for the second time, I go around and secure it. Now you'll notice that some of my fish are larger. I got those at Walmart to get three plump little fishies at Walmart for 99 cents. And they're rubber stamps. They were gorgeous. But I'm going to need some facing the other way so that I can put one on the front and one on the back. So I took an old piece of acetate, and then I took my image with my dark black ink, my detailed black, put it on the acetate, easy peasy, and then I placed it down. I just rub it onto the cardstock, and now I have reverse stamping. I have one fish facing one way and one fish facing the other, and I'll be able to put that other piece on the back. So I have a front and back piece that are identical because I need to hide the magnet we're using on some of the fish. And you will see how cutesy-wootsy that looks in just a little bit. Now when you're doing this and you turn it over, and if you notice when you pick it up, you don't have it very clear or there's missing a line, just take your Copic Multiliner and fill it in. It's that easy peasy. And then I just wiped off the ink and started again. And this time I put another little chubby fish, and I just ran it across for my reverse stamping so that one is facing one way, one the other. And then I took my, I think it's My Favorite Things, or Simon Says Stamp. I think it's Simon Says Stamp. They have the little fish that have the dies that go with it. So on my block, I put four of them, and then I am going to use all four, put it on my acetate. Well, I didn't right here. Isn't this the cutest fish? These are 99 cents at Walmart. Just fabulous. Just love them. They're so nice and clear, and one is facing one way and one the other. There was a few lines that were out, so I just took my precision pen and went over it. And it's a nice pigment pen, and it took well to the coloring mediums I was using, and it worked out wonderfully. I am so happy to be back in the craft room, and I will get caught up on my comments. The Apple computer changed the way the comments are put in there, and it's kind of confusing me. Learning something new all the time, right? But I will answer everybody's comments in time. I have just took some time over Christmas to rest from the pneumonia, and now I am back and ready to create. So thank you for your patience. So there we go. See how we have one face in the other one? Just by putting the ink on the acetate, rubbing it onto your cardstock, and there you go. You have reverse stamping perfectly. Look at that. One facing. Looks like the Incredible Mr. Limpet, doesn't it, with those lips? And then I had some inks there, the four cubes of the neon inks. So I slid them right across the chubby little fishes. And then I decided to do a little bit of doodle art on each one. And then I went over it with some colored pencils to add different color as I went on. And then, you know, I always take my black Copic marker. I go around the edges of the fish, and then on the other fish that's on the other side, I turn all of them over and I do them really thick. See how one is kissing the other? That reverse stamping with the acetate here, I'm going to show you how I did it again. And I am going to use, I think it's four little stamps I'll put down, and use my detailed black, onyx black ink. It works wonderfully, gives that dark, dark image. And then I'll turn it over, make sure no ink is on the block, and lift it straight up. You don't got to be careful not to slide it. Look how wonderfully detailed that is. And then I find a place on the cardstock, rub it in, and there you go. I have four quick reverse pieces. And if they're too light, all you have to do is color them in with your Copic precision pen. And now I'm using the dies that came with it, but you're going to have to turn this cardstock over to put the die on, right? So all I do is I hold it up to the light. You will see the image beautifully, and then have a piece of the MicroCore tape on your finger. And soon as you set it up in the light, I'll show you it. Here I'm just putting these ones on. You could put the tape down immediately, and then you run it through your a Vagabond or Big Shot, whatever you use, and you get a perfect cut. There it is. Look at that. I just hold it up to the light, and then I put my die on, and there you have it. Easy peasy reverse die cutting. Isn't that sweet? Yeah. You could do a card with them, you know, for Valentine's, kissing each other or swimming by each other. Or this way you can do a front and a back, because my magnets need to be hid behind these little fish. And we're going to use quite a bit of magnets because there's going to be quite a bit of fishing. As you can see, I have a lot of fish, yes. And I decided to use different coloring methods. So the first one I used are my Tri-Core pencils. I love them. And I'm just showing you how I just did ink to paper with the neon inks. And now I'm going to take these tri-pencils. They have three or four different lead colors all in one pencil. So you get your light tone, your medium tone, and your dark tone all with one swipe. It's wonderful. And look how beautiful the colored ones look on your acetate alcohol piece. And look at the bubbles. I mean, it's wonderful. This would make a beautiful starry sky card. You know, you could have a game card where you're fishing for stars. That would be awesome. Then I turned to my Copics and I did some Copic coloring, but you have to be careful because the Onyx Black ink is not Copic safe. And so I had them sitting overnight, so I knew they were nice and dry. So I was just careful and I went around the edges. But if you did use the Onyx Black ink, you can always use clear embossing powder right after you stamped it, and it would be wonderful. And then guess what came out? My irresistible sparkle. It's just like using glossy accents, but it's thinner and it dries so quickly you won't believe it. It has a little bit of sparkle, the wonderful look of glossy accents, and these fish came alive. I absolutely loved it. So now I set this down because when we make our block, see how we have to turn it in so it looks like a square block? But on the bottom and the top, I don't want a block. I don't want it to go in. I need it to go over top of the side pillars so that I had a ledge on the bottom to hold our magnetized fish. And I'll show you the easy peasy way to do this. But we do need to make an accordion to set on the side of this box that we made. And it's a 2-inch by 5-inch accordion, scored at the 1/2-inch mark. And then we're going to score it and fit it in there with double-sided tape. And then on the second score mark down the accordion, like inside the valley, we're going to place our acetate piece of alcohol ink water. That's what it's representing. And we're going to put it in there. And what a fun card. I wanted to make you something very special my first time back in the new year, and I hope you really like it. It's a wonderful card to make, interactive card that young children will love to play with. So now I knew I had to move my cutout one more time, right to the 4th score mark. So the first time we cut it at 3, but this time we're taking the 4th score mark out. So this is 1/2, 1/2, 1/2, 2 inches at the 1/2 mark, and look at that. It's out. And now you'll be able to make the box on the outside, and you'll be able to fold the bottom and the top over the boxes to hold it in place. And I'll show you that in a minute as well. Yes, it took some thinking, but when I got it finished and all the mathematics worked out, it was easy peasy, and you will love making this. Now we're going to have to seat this piece of acetate bubbles, and I want to have that bevel, right? So I need just a little bit more on one side, and once I take that out, we're going to start the assembly of the card, and we're going to make 2 accordion pieces to fit the right and left side columns there, the square columns, because we're going to be able to put our fishing rod down one of those because it's going to be hollow. So I'm just thinking here, okay, how am I going to have to do this? Do I have to cut anything more off? And once I get that planned out, we are going to take this to a whole new level, and it's going to be a goldfish card. So cutesy-wootsy. So here I know I'm going to need an extra inch all the way around. So I got out my cutting mat so that I could cut it with my knife. And right now I am just making sure with my T ruler I'm going to have 1 inch all the way around. And then I'm going to take the center out, and it's going to fit perfect after we make the front and back of the card. You'll see, yeah, my little fishes are sticking there. They're still drying, and I got them stuck onto the T-ruler. But anyway, that happened a lot. Yeah, get over there. Get over there. Quit swimming over by my card. Oh, yeah. I took a lot of breaks, like I said, worked a little bit each day on this, and I wanted to make sure that it was easy enough that everybody could make one. And so I took my time, and I thought it out, and right here, I'm just pulling it in 1 inch. So you'll have 1 inch frame all the way around, and then you'll take the guts out and you'll save that for another project. So in order to get the 1 inch here, I just folded the edge down so it didn't get in my way, so that I had the ledge for my ruler, and I'm measuring 1 inch. Then I'm going the opposite way and measuring, I'm just drawing the line, excuse me. And then I'll keep doing that. I'm gonna erase all of my lines there, and then I'm going to fold back all 4 of the edges and do the exact same thing. Measure in 1 inch, make a mark so that in a little bit of time, I could cut it out. Now, I looked over, and when I came back upstairs, I guess, I noticed all my fishies were dry on both sides. I colored both sides of all the fish. And I love the fact that they're all different sizes. The ones from Simon Says Stamp were tiny. They were nice for the magnets to go behind. And the big ones were awesome for decoration and filler. So wasn't that great? Just loved it. And I really do want to take another minute to just thank you for checking in on me. And I'm tapping my hand. What am I going to do here? Well, at the dollar store, you get four of these little cutters right here, little pink ones. So I use those, or you can use the Tim Holtz one that I had on the other side. And these are super duper sharp, so be careful. And then I switched rulers. I went to the Tim Holtz ruler because it has a metal edge and it's made for cutting. So that way I wouldn't slip and, have an accident there. So we're cutting out the 1 inch in the center, and then we're going to move on. Yeah, I'm just making sure that it's on the flat part, and let's cut that out. But as I was saying, I know that my friend Tina was so worried about me. Sorry, Tina. I really should have went on my blog, but I wasn't doing, I hardly opened up my computer, maybe 15, 20 minutes a day. I checked my comments, but I just made sure that I did take some time off to heal and get over that pneumonia. That was crazy. So now this is a 2-inch piece scored at a 1/2 inch. So when you lay it down, you have a 2-inch, then you have a half. Half makes 1 inch, half is 2 inches. And then you're going to do a valley and a hill. And I used my Teflon bone folder to make it nice and tight and flat. And this way, you're going to set your acetate piece in between the valley, the M, so that you can see it right there. And then you're going to cut it a little shorter so that you get the bevel. So that's what I came up with. I didn't know how else to do it so that I could get that acetate to make an S and bevel. So the only way I thought of was to make an accordion, put it inside the M part, the mountain, put it in the valley, put one on each side, cut it a little longer so that it would have time to make that little hill and valley, like a little S in the acetate part. So here I decided, okay, the 1/2 inch wasn't enough. I decided to do it in quarter increments. So as you can see here, it wasn't enough to have just the half, making 2 inches. I decided to make it in little wee quarter inch increments, and then just do the valley fold. Fold it in and out, and then take your Teflon or whatever bone folder you have, and then tighten that right up so that it's not so wide. And that's what I did here. Just kind of pull it together. Yes, this is going to work much better than having just the 2, the M. You'll see what I mean when I do this. And then you're going to have that accordion where you can push it down. Add some tape to the box so that it's even. Watch this. I'm putting it in the center. I'm going to add some double-sided tape, which I just did there. It's a 1/4 inch double-sided tape on the middle valley. I put the one side in first because this will let me know how much I have to cut off or leave on when I put the next accordion fold in there. And it'll make sense as soon as we carry along here. No worries, no worries. I did the best I could to make it very easy peasy for you. I don't know where I got the word worries. It's 1 o'clock in the morning. Yes. Oh, there it is. We put it down with double-sided tape. We have our accordion. We're going to be able to make it straight across by pushing it down to the box that we made and see how it's going to bevel. It's going to bevel beautifully. Wait till you see it. And then I'm going to put that 1/4 inch piece of tape in the center right here and just count up 2. And then I cut it off And I do the same for the right side. And look at that. As soon as you push it down, I have a piece of double-sided tape on the top as well. But we are going to add a frame around the whole top. So I'm just going to put Scotch tape to hold that down. So I'm just showing you here. We have the four pieces on the side of the large card to make that beautiful pillar, square pillar going down there. And then we have the mountain valley fold of 4/4 inch score marks. Yes, and this is 2 inches by 5 inches. I scored it at the half inch, and then I went in and scored it once again in between the half, so that I had, it would be 8/4 inch score marks. So there we go. Yes, which is really 4 once you get it folded down like an accordion. See, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then we're going to put double-sided tape. We're going to set it alongside where the box is. Make sure you make that box before you tape this down. You want to make sure it's right on that line we cut out there at the top of each one of the square panels. If you have any questions, just ask me in the comments, and I'll be sure to let you know if I can figure it out after that. Look at that. Yes. So really, it's just 2 accordion folds on the outside of the box that we make. And that the reason why we made those box pillars is to put, I wanted a spot to put the fishing rod. So here we have, oh, aren't they nice fishes? And then we're going to use basic gray magnets. These are the only magnets I use. They're crazy magnetized. They're thin and they're wonderful. I don't use any other ones. And you can get those online as well. So we're going to move along and put our magnets inside the smaller of the fish. See what I did? And then I had to put some double-sided tape. I think I used some dimensionals cut up just so that it would raise it up even with the magnet. I put my little fishy that matched, and I've got the irresistible glitter on top. Now, all of the fish have to have a negative magnet. Not a positive, put negative in all of the fishies. And then when we make the worm, we only use one positive, because the positive little worm will be able to pick up individually or all together your little fish. So here we go. We're going to black out all of the outside of these fish. I had to cut those larger ones from Walmart out by hand, but aren't they cute? I made some with little teeth. Little buck teeth. Oh, I'm telling you, I used googly eyes. I used, so many little extras on these. And then here I went over the larger ones with the black around the edges, because I didn't want to be able to see inside them. Now look at this worm. He has 2 fat little cheeks. I'm going to be using the one on the bottom. But he has 2 little fat cheeks and little googly eyes, and it's going to be able to fit the magnet. I had to make sure, see the magnet right there, the negative magnet right in the middle of his head. I cut 2 of them out, and 1 for the front, 1 for the back, and I traced around with my precision black pen so it, the little wee, I called it Wilhelmina worm. It was Willy, but then it looked like a girl when I was done, so I called her Wilhelmina. And I'm going to color her with a gold Copic, not gold, kind of like, yeah, gold mustard, like the color of a worm. And then I put the 2 googly eyes on one side and then just 2 little dots on the other. And we'll get back to that in just a minute. The magnets on each side that we folded. So we folded those so that they had 1/4 inch. It started with a 2 inch wide, and I scored in all the way at the 1/4 inch mark on my Martha Stewart score mini scoreboard. I put a piece of double-sided tape in the middle, because this is where the acetate's going to go. But first, I want to put the look of glass on the outside to protect the outside of the aquarium. So I just made some marks, took my Tim Holtz large scissors, because it's not going to, you don't have to worry about being that even, because you're going to use Scotch tape to hold it in the center there. And these are my page protectors. Remember I showed you we got those at the stationery store? These are thicker than normal acetate. And I really do like them, but they cut super well. And with my Guillotine Fiskars cutter, just like butter, loved it. So let's cut off the acetate page protector there for the one side. You're actually going to need two of these. So if you're doing it, cut two, and that would be perfect because each side is the exact same measurement. So I grab my Scotch tape and I put that down, and there you have it, just making sure it's going to fit. Hey Lou, I missed everybody. Yes, I did. I sure did. I wanted to come up in the craft room so many times, but I decided to make sure that I was, healed of this pneumonia, and I feel so much better, and it's great to be back. So here we go. We're fitting them in. We already took the backing off of the double-sided tape in the middle, and then you will see it has a little fold in it, like a little S, and look at our little fish. Oh, they're so cute. Now the bottom, I want to have a one gully, yet I need to fold it over so that it goes over top of the pillar. So I'll show you what I mean here. I'm just grabbing some of my extras. These fish I want to put little teeth on, little buck teeth. Make them look really funny so that whoever gets this birthday card will just adore it. And there's my worm. Look at Wilhelmina. She is so cute. I'm testing to see which ones have the magnet and which ones don't. And then I went, and you're not going to believe it, I found a necklace that had a hook on it. Yes, you know the hooks that you hook on the end of a bracelet, kind of? And it had the exact clear for holding the fish down, clear wire. I couldn't believe it. It was just made to be. This was card game was made to be. See how the wire, the invisible thread there is making the fish go back and forth, and you're going to be able to see it from the front or from the back. How cool is that? Now, as you can see, I had two Coca-Colas going back there, but really, just the one with the straw was for today. I don't drink them two at a time. Honestly, I don't. There, I got rid of one. I thought, oh, look at that. That doesn't look good. But anyway, it tasted good. Oh, yeah. Ice cold with a straw. Mm-mm. So now I'm taking my invisible thread and I'm putting it behind the fish, and I'm making them go at different levels so they're not straight across. I'm using my hot glue to secure it to the top of the acetate. And the acetate being so thick, it didn't bother it at all. Look at this. Is that cute or what? Yeah, it's hard to see all the bubbles right now, but you'll get to see it in a bit. And then I found this little wee... I took a bunch of beads off this, and look at a perfect hook. I mean, oh, the Lord is good. I did not want to have to make something, and I went into my beading, and there it was, a hook. Perfect. And then that string is so nice and thin that when I make the fishing pole, I'm going to use that really thick tape, and it's going to work out perfect. I think you're going to love it. So look for one of those little clasp bracelets that if it doesn't have nice beading on it, just cut it off. So here I have my half inch tape. I'm going to put it down on here, three, just around the outer edge of the side panels. And then we're going to wait until I get this. Today I was just trying to see, okay, how am I going to, I got to make sure that this is perfect. So I take the double-sided tape off here. I'm going to make my square column and make it even, right like that. Be careful there. And then I have to take the bottom part and fold it up so that there's only one crease on the bottom for the fish to set in, and it works beautifully. I put some half-inch double-sided tape going down here as well, all the way across, holding down all of it. So it holds down that quarter-inch little piece I had on the accordion and the half-inch on the other side. So look at that. Isn't that perfect? Love it. Love it. Love it. I'm going to do exactly the same on each side, and we are going to fold it. Then I'm going to raise this up. You're going to see, I thought of putting it down, like cutting it and putting it in to have another ledge, but I thought, no, I have to have it missing on the inside so that those fish have that ledge. See it right there? Where they can rest at the bottom so that when my little worm goes down there, it has some space to attach itself to another magnet. So here what I'm doing is, let's see, move over, Carol. You are totally out of frame. But, oh, I just need to cut a piece off that wasn't even. Then I'm thinking, how am I going to do this here? I keep going over and over it, and when it finally hits me that I want to have that ledge, I'm going to bring up the bottom and the top, grab my scotch tape here, and that's how I'm going to secure it, because remember, we are going to use the mink machine, and I'm going to have a beautiful cover for both the front and the back. So make sure right here that you have scotch tape ready, because once I fold this up, we are going to be moving quite quickly to finish it off. And then you're going to use the other sheet of acetate for this side as well. So here we go. I've got scotch tape in my hand. You can see I folded that up. I've got 1 inch, right, when I fold it up because it's scored at half and half. So you're going to move it over the 1 inch and tape it down right on top of that folded square column. And then you're going to do the same at the bottom. It gives you a little bit of a ledge to put your scotch tape. And doesn't that look wonderful? It looks just like a fish tank. Once you put the acetate down on this side, then the cover goes on. It is beauteous. I just had so much fun making this. I can't even tell you. And all it did was start with 2 pieces of acetate and some alcohol inks. And then, you know, you get your mojo going, and this is what I envisioned was a goldfish game box, and I wanted bright colors, and I wanted to have some fun on my first 2017 project. So now I have to cut the top off, one of them. Wherever you're going to put the fishing rod down, you have to have a space to put it down there, right? So you know where we attached the wire? The actual string, the invisible string, that's where I cut out the top of the box, and I'll show you in just a minute. So you have the fish, then right at the top there, I'll straighten that up later. You see how you have the hole, the square hole to fit your fishing pole? And now let's tape it down securely. You're not going to see that because we're going to have another sheet over top. And that's the sheet that we make, and we cut it out. I'm just taking all the rough edges off, and it just made me happy to see. I had the spaces to put the fishing rods. You could have 2 of them. If you had, say, twin girls and you wanted to give them each a fishing pole, you could put one on each side inside the hole at the top. So now I'm putting the numbers on the fish, right? Because goldfish, you have to have numbers. So I numbered them. I did them in threes, like 1, 3, 5, 7, 15, 10. I think I did all odd numbers. I can't remember. But I made them small. But this way, you get a piece of paper, and they get to play the game. And whoever gets the most by picking up the fish, win. There you go. You have a little 3, you have a 6 down in the fin, and we are on the way to making this gorgeous little card. And this, I've added stickles to this, and I want the gold chest here to hang as well. And I thought it was beautiful. I needed to put my backing on it, and I stamped that as well with the acetate so I could do the double stamping, the reverse stamping, so that there it is, matches perfectly. Then I just took my Copics and my pencil. I wrote, "Go fish." Oh, yes. That's what's going on the front of the card. And here's my little funny ones. I took a pen. I made smiles. I took my white, I can't think of the name of it right now, but I made buck teeth on my fish just for some little silliness. And I will put down what that is. I don't know why I can't think of it right now. It's not the irresistible. It is the, it has that big diamond thing on the top. We'll have a game. We'll have goldfish as a game. And what is Carol talking about? Oh, yes. Oh, yeah. It's 1:15 in the morning. Look at that one. Look at that fish with all the crazy teeth. I did all his teeth kind of pointy. It's so cute. Look at. Just really cute. I love him. This was a happy, happy project for you today. And now we have to move on to design the fishing pole. So I put scotch tape holding that invisible thread. Look at Wilhelmina. It's Willie on one side and Wilhelmina on the other. Two little, the little couple, let's call them. And look at that. I'm just showing you how it picks up the magnetized fish so easy. You can even get 3 or 4 of them on there. That's how much, yes. Wow, what fun. Those magnets will suction onto 2 or 3 of those fish without a problem. All right, here's the paper that I used through my mink. A hologram, I think it's called. And when you're finished, it looks like rainbow colors going through each stripe. It is fabulous. It made this card. It made the water marks pop because each one of these colors in the hologram, I think it's called, even my little boidy, oh, I love it. Just love it. Let's hang out. There we go. I ran 2 pieces through, and that's exactly how it looks in the light. It's beautiful. Then I grabbed this super, super duper duct tape in black. I cut it, and I folded it in half, and then I cut it along the edge of my fishing pole, and I thought it's really nice because it will keep. It won't break because it has the wood underneath, and look at that. We're going to make the outside shell 1 inch all the way around. Take out your cutting knife. Make sure you have your mat underneath there and cut out around the 1 inch. And then we're going to attach that to the front and the back so that it looks like a beautiful fish aquarium tank. Look at the colors that shine off that. Absolutely beautiful. Look at over there. Look at that. Ah, oh, this paper, this mink sheets in this color is stunning. Simply stunning. Now you're going to have to make sure you put your acetate down before this. So I'm putting the double-sided tape on over top of the piece of acetate that's underneath. And then I am going to put that gorgeous. See how it's underneath there? I already put it down. And then we are going to use this it's 1 inch tape, excuse me, because all the way around here is 1 inch. And the reason why I cut the center out of that hologram mink foil is I didn't want to have any seams. I want it to look virtually seamless. Yes. So here we go. We have the 1 inch all the way around of the double-sided sticky tape. And then we're going to move on, take it off, and put this gorgeous, gorgeous. This is the black sheets of 140 cardstock I take into my stationery store, and I have them run it through the black laser. and I get it a super black, and then I bring them home, and that way I can run it through my mink instantly by just putting the foil over top. It's affordable and it's quick and easy peasy. So look at that. Now we're going to do the same on the other side, taking the 1-inch double-sided tape off, put that gorgeous, gorgeous foil over top, and we're going to be just about finished. But then remember that Vertigo paper I have? That it's really plasticky and it looks like water. You get it at Joann's, Michael's Hobby Lobby. I decided to put that on the sides, but I knew it needed to have some ocean, you know, some ocean, what do they call them, trees or little ocean limbs or seaweed, whatever you call it. So I had some gold that looked like stickers that looked like seaweed. So I put it on this each corner of both sides. And then I had these little flowers there, like really light, bubbly plastic. Not plastic. Boy, I'm going to have to remember all this. Then I found this bag of beautiful stones, clear stones. So I used the ready pink ones. So pretty. I put, see on the holes on the bottom, because if you put your fishing rods through there, you don't want it falling out the bottom. So I took the round stones and I put hot glue. There it is, like that. Isn't that awful? I can't even think of the name of that. Styrofoam. Those styrofoam little flowers that you always see hanging around thrift stores. And there we go. I matched up the colors to the foil, and we're almost finished. There's the Vertigo paper. Actually, it's not paper. It is thick, thick plastic. I cut it off and I put it around all the edges so that it did look like water all the way around. Just gorgeous. And then I'm just cutting it to make sure there's no hard edges going across. And we're almost finished, my friends. I just really hope you liked this and that you will give it a go for a GoFish game card for the next birthday person that you have to make for. And there's, I'm going to show you, I'm going to go fishing. Watch. There's my worm. I'm going a little fast. I should have slowed this down, but look at him wiggle around. The kids will love this, okay? So I'm going to put him, do I put him back in? Oh, maybe not now. I grabbed some polka dotted ribbon to put alongside, you know, where we put the glue dots to hold the invisible thread for the fish to hang. I wanted to cover that. Well, I hope you enjoyed this card and that you will get some inspiration to make one for next birthday. I had a wonderful day creating it in between the wonderful inauguration today. Oh, my heart was just blessed watching that. And I want you to have a wonderful, blessed weekend. And I just thank you for all your support. Thank you for your comments and your cards that you sent. Get well cards from my friends. I appreciate that. I sent some boxes and cards out on Tuesday. So some will be receiving some goodies this week. And actually next week. So thank you, everybody. There you have it. I have some pictures for you to enjoy. And God bless you for the year 2017. Take care, my friends, and I'll see you on the next video.